Hello everyone, welcome to JSPM TSSM Group of Institutes, Civil Engineering Department. Right now we are standing in the Strength of Material Labs. Today we are going to see a practical on tension test on mild steel bar. For this tension test on mild steel bar, we are having a UTM, that is Universal Testing Machine. You can see over here, the apparatus which are required for this test are mild steel bar and a UTM machine. Let's start with the practical procedure. So, in this universal testing machine, we are having two jaws, among which one jaw is fixed and another jaw can be movable in downward and upward side. We are having some knobs over here. These are the downward knob, these are the upward knobs. These buttons are used for starting the machine and this is for stopping. These are the two knobs, or we can say two gears, in which one gear is closed while performing the experiment. This is the digitalized meter, okay, for performing should be closed, and another knob is used for applying the pressure while performing the experiment. Now we will going to fix this specimen into these two jaws. First of all, we will fix this specimen into the lower jaw by using this wheel. Okay, so in this there are some grips which are inside these lower jaw, and in that we have to fix this specimen. Now by using this hand wheel, we have to tighten the wheel and for this, in this way we have fixed the specimen in the lower jaw. Now by using this button of upper, this jaws will get moves to the upward side. Now we have fixed the specimen into the upper jaw, and by using this hand wheel, we will tighten the specimen. Okay, or you can use a spanner for tightening this, for making this specimen fixed into the upper jaw. By using the ruler, we have to measure the distance between these two jaws. Okay, so that we can find the displacement which takes place during the elongation process of this specimen. Now the next step will be, these are the two knobs in which one knob should be closed to the left hand side. It will get open to the left hand side, and it will get closed to the right hand side. In clockwise direction it gets closed, and in anti-clockwise direction it gets open. So we have to close this knob, and this knob also we have to keep closed. Okay, while performing the experiment, we have to first tear these readings which are displaying over this display. Okay, then while performing the experiment, we have to release this knob to apply the constant hydraulic pressure over that specimen. Now on this switch, now the process gets start. We have to apply the pressure by releasing this knob. You can find readings over here. As I release the knob, the load gets increases. This should be in kilonewton. By releasing this knob, a constant hydraulic pressure is applied over the lower jaw of the UTM. So at the starting stage, the stress and strain which is induced in this specimen will remain constant. Means by drawing the graph of stress versus strain curve, it will show a uniform displacement, or you can say it will show uniform elongation inside the bar. as the test is performing, we are getting some results over there. So for that, before the performing the test, we have to find the gauge length for this specimen. So gauge length should be equal to 5 times the diameter of this bar. So gauge length means the distance between this much portion is called as gauge length, and diameter of the bar can be calculated with the help of vernier caliper. This is a 12 mm 5 bar,